The house looked creepy enough, but what officers heard coming from inside was even worse. In fact, the shrieks sounded like something was in pain. Of course, though, it was impossible to guess what horrors were inside, so the cops steeled themselves as they crossed the dilapidated threshold. Late on the night of July 6, 2015, officers for the Chicago Police Department discovered an apparently haunted house. Creepy as the place was, however, it was the unusual sounds that tipped the cops to there being something truly amiss. Naturally, then, the officers cautiously went inside to investigate. As the noises became clearer, they realized they were hearing screams. Moreover, the distressed shrieks seemed inhuman, like something was writhing in torment. So, with flashlights in hand, the officers intrepidly searched to find the source. And while it wasn't danger that they discovered in the shack, what they saw did certainly hurt. In fact, it broke their hearts. Yes, when the officers finally spotted what was producing the cries, they had to do a double take. Two dogs were near death from starvation inside the abandoned house, and they looked like they'd been there for ages. Sadly, the poor creatures were so thin that they were just skin and bones. So after calling Trio Animal Foundation, TAF, the cops quickly took their charges to get veterinary care. The shocking discovery must have really stunned the brave officers. Thankfully, the animal hospital was open, even though it was now 1 a.m. The TAF staff met the dogs, therefore, and named the red female Emmy and the white male pit bull Oscar. Yes, police transferred care of the pooches to TAF, which would pay for the dogs' medical expenses, and left them in the capable hands of the vets. The Trio Animal Foundation is a charitable organization that assists shelters, rescues, and individuals by paying the medical bills of homeless pets, its website states. TAF also promotes adoption and responsible pet ownership, including spay and neuter. So it would do all that it could for poor Oscar and Emmy, and yet the dogs were very sick. Emmy's severely underweight at only 24 pounds. She should be close to double that, TAF wrote. Her blood work showed that her body is in starvation mode and she's anemic. But Emmy wasn't even the one who was most at risk. Sadly, Oscar's in worse shape. His body has gone into starvation mode and he's suffering from hypophosphatemia. He's dangerously close to liver failure, the group explained. Both of the dogs were close to death. Their survival over the next few days was questionable. In fact, after going so long without proper sustenance, the dogs might potentially react badly to food and nutrients. Yes, their conditions were so severe that the issue would have to be approached carefully. For this, then, they needed a special feeding regime. Emmy is receiving IV fluids and several small meals a day, TAF reported. Given how thin she is and that her system is essentially depleted, we need to be very careful how much and what she eats. The same was true of Oscar. Oscar and Emmy are both on a slow feeding regimen to prevent refeeding syndrome, which could overwhelm their starved systems and cause organ failure and even death, the group explained in a social media post. Several small, high-fat meals are fed over the course of the day. After some time, TAF reported that, despite her bony appearance, Emmy was actually doing a little better than Oscar. In fact, her condition was stabilizing, and she was more aware of her surroundings. She was also able to keep food down, and yet her companion was still struggling for survival. However, after careful treatment with electrolyte supplements and medication, Oscar started to recover as well. On July 29, 2015, TAF updated their progress on their patients with amazing photos. In less than a month, it seemed, the dogs had gained weight and had their naturally happy demeanors back intact. And the good news didn't stop there. Emmy fell for one of her vet technicians and he fell for her, TAF wrote. When Emmy was weak and didn't want to leave Anthony's side, he would drape her around his neck and carry her around like a little fawn. This is when Emmy was happiest. Emmy would even walk through the hospital to find Anthony when she was strong enough. Indeed, the two couldn't bear to be apart from each other. And by late August, Anthony had become Emmy's new human. He couldn't lose his favorite girl, TAF reported. By this point, Oscar and Emmy had become socially independent. That meant each dog could enjoy a walk without needing the other one there for support, and that they would play with the other dogs as well. This was critical too, as the two would need to be adopted to two different homes. But before Oscar could get adopted, he still needed further training to reduce his anxiety and fear. Indeed, poor Oscar seemed to be having a hard time overcoming his past experiences. Oscar's shown some significant behavioral issues that we're not taking lightly, the charity stated. But Trio Animal Foundation didn't give up on him, and he was assigned to emotional and behavioral therapy. And with the help and support he needed, Oscar worked through his problems. In fact, after 2 months of rehabilitation, he proved that he could be a loving and affectionate companion. So by September 14, 2015, he was finally ready to start looking for his forever home, and he wasn't looking for long. By September 29, 2015, an experienced bulldog owner who could carry on the dog's training adopted Oscar. As a plus, Oscar even got a new canine sister. Naturally, TAF was grateful to everyone involved with the dog's rescue and support. And with their help, these two award-winning fur babies got the second chance they truly deserved.